Okay, here we go. Hey, you two, is the only place gonna get it. It's right back at the base. Chunk of the deuce is how we do it, Texas, baby. Man out of Dallas back. You know what it is. Real man rise up, fake man rise down. Real women rise up, fake women rise down. Proud to our preach and preach on. I want to talk about this, man, and I really want to do this video, and there's something barely on my mind lately on this show. I'm going to talk about being used to. Do y'all know what it's like to be used? What I'm talking about when you're being used by friends, family, loved ones. You're being used, especially you're being used, man. And a lot of times when you don't know and when you feel it in your heart. I've been used, you've been used, everybody been used every single day. That's what people do. Men use women use men. That's just how it is. People, you're going to get used at some point. Rich, the poor, black and white, middle class, everybody been used. Gay or straight, everybody been used. I really want to talk about this because do y'all know what it's like being used? Before everybody, I just want really people to get to know me, what I really am, what I really came from. My real name is DeMarcus Mitchell. I'm 25 years old. I'm living with my family. I don't have no kids. And, you know, I live my life. I just keep imagining and keep on living. For all the folks out there who really, quite a few people do like me, shout out to y'all. But the ones who don't, hey, I understand, but you don't know me like you think you know me. I'm going to tell you like this. The reason why I want to do this video right here because my brother got a good heart. He do got a good heart. And I love my little brother to death. He got a good heart. He does got a good heart, but a lot of times he could be too helpful for folks, especially people, and for anybody. You know, when you feel like you're being used, and he remind me of my old self, how I used to be. I'm not always like this, man. People might think I don't care, I don't cry or nothing like that, but man, I do care. Because for all y'all folks out here that think y'all know me, y'all don't know me like y'all think y'all do. Y'all don't know me. Same thing I don't know about y'all. Y'all really don't know me. I do care. It's just sometimes, man, you hide your tears in the blind eyes and the private eyes. You know, you want to be private. I hide my tears. I hide my hurt. I hide my pain because I don't want people to show. I don't want to show people. Show everybody who the real me, who I really am. Only thing I can show to that to my family, to my friends, and sometimes it could be loved ones, and someone that's really close to me. Because I'm not gonna show anybody, because people will take advantage of that. Because I lost my innocence a long time ago. I have, because I've been used. I've been taken advantage of. I've been talked about. I have. I went going on. And I ain't never did nothing to anybody. But it's like, but you try to be a good person. But sometimes people take advantage of that. You know, people going to take advantage of it. But sometimes I feel like I'm the only one. But I'm not the only one. There's a lot of people out here who do feel the same way I do. The reason why I'm speak about this because my brother got a good heart. And he been used. And I don't think sometimes he know it. I think he know it, but sometimes he make sure he don't being used. Cause my brother is very tempted heady, very tempted. He got a temper. But pleasant. He very quietable pleasant. You don't see it, but when you see it, it's there. But his stuff is not worse than mine. I get really angry. I get really upset. I get really fussed the hell out of that. Frustrated. And the reason why I'm doing this is because, you know, people, I'm going to tell you right now, don't be used and don't use other people. Because the reason why I'm saying this to get to um, to be to be get used and getting used and get by used, because they're gonna become bad like everybody else. Don't do it. I learned this lesson, like, as I use a person and somebody use me. I learned this, and that's probably why I act the way I am now. And I'm trying to change. I'm trying to be a better person than I can be. I try. Sometimes I like to be in private for myself, and not just get away from towards everyone. I mean, you know, it's not just because of that. You know, I don't want people worried about me like nothing wrong, like something is wrong with me. But I'm doing all right. I'm doing okay. I'm just keep myself busy much as possible. But I do take a break sometimes, and you know, because I hate to be the kind of person I don't like depend on people. I hated that you really, you know, when you try to ask people for a favor, nothing deliver as return. I never understand that. One thing that's really upsets me, I'm upset about is that when you expect the people do something for, you do something for them, when you expect people do something for you, they don't no help is nothing return. But they expect you to do something them, all of a sudden everything is all good. That's what I don't like about it. I hate when people do that. I hate to feel like you gotta do so much for everybody. It could be your own, it could be everyone else. If you ever feel used like that, man, raise your hand in the air. If you ever feel like you're being used, and you being used to other folks, because I know I learned this lesson, and that explains why people the way they are now, because they can't trust anybody anymore. It's not about love anymore. It's not about none of that, man. It's about every man, every woman for themselves. That's what it's about. Anybody helping out one another. Just like I'm glad I did a good deed, try to help out this homeless person, because this guy was homeless. And he trying to get something to eat and ride a bus. And I'm glad I did that. Me and my mom and my brother, we did that. Because there are people out here who steal stuff from the starving every single day. But they don't care about that. Now it's about money. It's about being famous, being rich and famous. Who gives a damn about that? It's about sex and it's about crime. That's what it's always a damn. That's what it's always been about. It ain't about love. It ain't about unity. It ain't about justice and freedom of them all. It ain't about that anymore. Those days are long gone. They're long gone. They out of history forever. And we need to get that back, because I'm telling you something. I've been used once, twice, and at the third time, I can't deal with it anymore. And I know I'm not going to be using people, because I did one time, and I learned that lesson. I learned that lesson, and I know what it feels like, because there was a special female in my life, and I messed that up, and see what that happens. And I try to move on, and at least I'm moving on and learn sometimes, because I really feel like I don't deserve a good girl, because I've been hurt so much, and I just don't know how to combat it, how to deal with it. You know, especially when you're a good person. When you're a good person, you have a good heart, people will take advantage of that. They will do it. You become bad to everybody else. They expect you to fuck up. They expect you to mess things up. It could be frustrating. Excuse my language, but I know it just have a peaceful moment, but I gotta say this. It could be frustrated sometimes. It could be really frustrated when you're trying to do what's right. You're not trying to do what's wrong. You're doing what remained right in the first place. That's what this world should be about. But I guess, man, people get way out of their head and way out everybody's lead. It's not about that anymore. Those days are far gone. I mean, we're in American crisis right now as a people, as everybody, man. We fight over democracy, hypocrisy. We fight over about race, sexuality, religion. We over money, over relationships, over children. I mean, we fight over all of that, man. And we still empty inside. We still empty. And the reason why I'm saying this, man, because I know I'm not alone. And I'm glad I'm doing YouTube videos, because I'm doing something that no other people would not do, especially coming out here in Dallas. I love my city. I love my home, and this is where I come from. Even though it can be irritated sometimes, but no matter where I go, Dallas, I can always come back home here. But it's just and Triple D stand up. But it's what's really sad, man. It's like I don't even listen to music no more. Music is really, it's just like a broken toy box, just ready to pop up. Ready to pop up, like Pop Goes the Weezer, Pop Goes the Weezer, Weasel Diesel. It just dead off to me. I just stopped listening to it because music has always been my heart, my passion, my heart and dedication. That's what really what am I, because that's what really in my rite of passage that I will go is music. But I just want to do it for the fans, from the love, from the helping out a lot of people. With the people that do need help, not the ones that don't need help, but the people that do need help. Because, you know, the way it is time right now, we got to help out each other, especially with those that need it the most, and expect to do the favor. Don't just help out people and they ain't doing you no favor. What's the point doing it? And the reason why I'm saying this, because it's hard sometimes. It's hard that, and I'm tired of going walking every time in the damn sidewalk. Me and my family, I need to get a car because and you know, I'm going to tell you like this. I love my family. My family can be dysfunctional, but it's still my family and I love them. I love my brothers and sisters and my dad and my mom and all that other stuff because I know we're not the Huxtables. We're not all these other family. We're just everyday family. And I tell you this, though, and maybe I can family on my own for it can break the cycle, for it won't repeat it for itself. Because my brother been taken advantage of, and I think he knew it in by heart, but he felt like that there's no other friend he should have. And I think he's lonely deep inside, and I can feel it. And I know what it's like when you're lonely, because I always been a loner. But there ain't nothing wrong having a few people with you. As long as they do the same of favor to you, you do the favor for them. One thing I always say, I would never take advantage of people. I never disrespect for nobody because I know what it's like somebody did me like that. But sometimes, man, it just make you angry and make your skin just turn to bloodshot red. Because you just ready out for kill. You get tired of that. You get tired of trying to do something for folks and there's nothing returns. It could be like that for friendships. It could be like that for family. It could be like that for loved ones. But what hurts the most, your family. That's what hurts. Your own family that thinking that they will be the together forever. Your family will hurt you than anybody. And family supposed to be together like this forever. No matter what happens. But only time family come together for funeral homes and family reunion. And get together. That's the only time family come together like that. And this day of grace, because that's what family should be. Like friends. Friends hurts, but not friends used to be more hurt than family. But family is more hurt than friends. How many of us have them as friends? The ones that we can depend on, the ones we cannot depend. The one we can depend on, the one we cannot depend on as friends. If y'all have friends, you know what I'm saying. Cause some okay and some that treat you like some okay, some real cool, and some will treat you like a fool, like a foolish fool. Because we like to be with friends because they funny. Other times they need around, they need some money. And Houdini, I learned that from Houdini. Houdini was a line about that song right there, Friends. And I have friends, but I have friends that's turned on me. And I ain't gonna mention their names on YouTube because they know what I'm talking about. Two friends turned on me. Two or three friends turned on me. Three of them turned on. One of them turned on me five or six, 7 years ago. I was trying to go to his house and ask him to see what he was doing. His sister didn't answer the door, but she was speaking through the damn door. She could have opened the door and tell me that he wasn't there, but I believe he was there. And I didn't say nothing since. I ain't went to his house since. And when I see him in my job, I didn't say nothing to him. but I'm not going to hold my grudge. I'm going to forgive that. But I just think that's wrong doing that, because you don't do friends like that. You don't do friends, especially that's the one that's trying to be there for you. And this is the same friend that I know that I got into a fight. In an act of combat with a person, went into a fight years ago when I was in elementary. He stood up for me, and I stood up for him. We went way back to the third grade, way back. But what hurts the most, your friends would change and overnight. Over more, it would change. You would think they're not the same friends. I know this other friend I know. How you gonna tell a friend to call you 10 minutes, and after they call you 10 minutes, you don't want to be bothered? I didn't like that shit. I did not like it. Excuse my lane, but I got to say what I feel. I did not like that. I called him back and let him know, hey, if you don't want to be bothered, let me know. He taught me all this religion, but he don't even practice where he preach. And I don't want to see this dude, man, because personally, I have to forgive that. People say you got to forgive, and I'm trying. And I got to forgive, but I let them know, don't do me like that, man. I ain't never do you like that, so why you do me as a friend? And we went way back from high school, since the 12th grade, and I'm in 11th grade, 10th grade. And that's messed up. 2 or 3 years ago, that's messed up. You're going to do me like that. Friends would change, man. I ain't gonna lie. Friends change. And another friend, like this person I know, he worked from Lake Hollins. Not this other friend I'm talking about. The other friend, and the one I'm talking about did me wrong, but this other friend. And we talking, you know, and talking, like hanging out, cool buddies or whatever. But somehow he have a family, which I can understand that. But every time he called me, he said he gonna call me back. He never called me back. So I'm not even worried about that. I just think that's a little bit messed up, but I can get over that. But if you say you're gonna call back, call back. If you say you're not, then don't call back. You know, I just did not like that shit. I hated it. I did not like that nonsense right there. Because I've been used once or twice. Third, but I just can't deal with it anymore. Because let me focus on me. Let me focus on my problems, my issues, and the things I got to deal with. But what's really hurts, your loved ones. Loved ones like girlfriends. And girlfriend. It could be girlfriend, boyfriend, but girlfriends, man. I mean, I love women. Don't get me wrong. But sometimes women, man, I ain't lying to you, man. When you a nice guy, quote unquote nice guy, man, I swear to God, it could be a pain in your ass when you try to be a nice guy. They'll take advantage of you. But I always ask myself, why they won't do the bad boy and a jerk like that? So I start react what they do. You know, I start studied it all and kept studying about the bad boys and jerks and doing. And I said, okay, in order to them get women, I'm gonna come off as a bad boy influence, and become have a bad boy influence and come off as a jerk. I can still be a good guy, but I ain't gonna let nobody use me. I ain't gonna let no woman use me. Real talk. And I damn sure ain't use her. But I learned a lesson, because that was a real person in my heart. But I messed that up years ago in high school, because I guess I've been used so much. One thing us fellas, we don't know what a real woman is. It stares us right in the face. And we don't know about it, because we interact with fast women, disrespectful, nasty women. Man, forget those women. No women ain't worth nothing. Ain't worth a brown Abraham Lincoln's penny. They ain't worth nothing. Only thing they ain't worth is sexing up. That's all they good for, and laying on their ass. That's all they good for. But I keep it true. I just keep it 100 the truth right here. Real truth percent right here, that everything I'm speaking of, the realest thing I have to say right here. And another, I'd rather have a good woman I could be with for a long time and still be faithful, have wife and kids, because I want a woman I can come home with every morning, but every night. every day, every morning, because mess with a lot of women is not worth it. It's really not. But sometimes I feel like I don't deserve a good woman. I go back to my bachelor's day. That's why if I don't can't have kids then, I'm going to stay a free agent. Use a lot of condoms because I'm not going to have no babies by different women. I'm not going to do that. It's not worth for that. I ain't gonna collect no damn child support or no damn divorce. Forget that. Now separated ain't no problem. But all this other stuff, no. I'm not gonna make the same mistakes like all these other men that you hear every day on their teens and their 20s. Because men gotta hold themselves accountable when, especially in their 20s. Especially in really their teens, because when you get women, that's when you get money. Because only women want you because you got money. Because quite a few women only love you for you because you got a sense of heart, and she will be there for you. But sometimes men will take advantage of that those women. I did. I learned that lesson. Now I got to deal with it because man, I should have been. Because now. It really hurt me when I found out this woman had a baby by somebody else. And I knew that stuff was going to happen. But it's my fault because I could have been there. I should have done something about it. I should have. But one thing I learned, I make the same mistakes, but not to make the same mistakes twice. Because I will never let that happen again. Even though I'm moving on. But you got to go. You got to keep on living. You got to keep living on. You got to. And this time, if I would have had a choice to make it up, I wouldn't make it up for all the things that I miss out of. But I tell you like this, man, you know, family, friends, and loved ones, they'll hurt you. They'll hurt you. But sometimes you hurt the family and you hurt friends and loved ones. Even I hurt the family sometimes, you know. I hurt the family like my other sister, you know. Even though, man, I love my older sister. Even though she got that loud mouth, but it's still my sister. And I understand her pain, you know. I get that. You know why she act like that, you know. I get it, you know. Even though we're not the best in terms, but we're trying to get to past that, you know. And I love my other sister as well. Because I understand we're not perfect. You know, we're not as human beings. We're not. You know, and I don't mean to hurt my older sisters. My older sisters, because, you know, I was irritated and ignorant at the same time. I was irritated and ignorant. But I'm trying to be positive as much as I can, everything that I lost. Because I wasn't always used to be like that. I used to be a good person. I still am. But I kind of lost my innocence a long time ago. Man, I just said it myself in one of my videos. When I lost my virginity, messing around with these women out here, these fast women, and disrespectful, nasty women, I feel like I sold my soul to the devil. My hands down. Hands down, just... I swear, I felt bad and felt guilty about it. And to this day, it still teared up in my heart deep inside. Because I'm talking about my life experience. The things I know, the things I live for, I regret to live for, you know. But at the age I'm in, 25, I'm getting too old for this. And I ain't getting a lot younger. I ain't getting no younger. And I want a wife and the kids. Because I'm not going to go around mess with a lot of females. They not worth it. Fellas, they not worth it. I'm telling you right now, it's better to have a wife for you can come home every day and play with the kids. It's not worth it unless you got to be a bachelor and get accepted. Me, if it's not, use a condom. Because put a teacup in it. Because make sure you can hold your Johnsons up. Because I'm telling you, you got guys out here who keep making the same mistakes over and over and over and over and over again. I'm not going to keep making the same mistakes over and over and over and over again. I'm not going to keep making the same mistakes. And even though I didn't want no family, but sometimes I missed out on that. You know, and I look around, there was something missing in my heart. There was something was missing. I try to play it off like it ain't nothing. I ain't miss anything, but I do miss something, a family. But I'm not going to make the same mistakes as my father did and his great-grandfather did. And we as men, I understand that we're not perfect. We're perfect, but we're less than perfect. We need to know when we're wrong. And when right, we'll prove where we're right. And same thing as women. When women need to know when they admit they're wrong, they're wrong. If they're right, they're right. And prove they're right. I mean, men and women are the both of the problem. And the system itself, and how the media portrays men and women, especially men and women relationships. I mean, you know, we need to get our asses, get the head of our asses, and do some job and do some living working around here, because we got a lot of crises and we need to get rid of. You know, not just for our community, but our family, our friends, and even loved ones, but ourselves. Because I'm gonna tell you, you know. We got to stick together no matter what. Hold your ground no matter what, and find the truth in your heart. And believe me, you will find the truth. They'll set you free. But fight the evil, man. Don't let the evil men revolve in your lives, destroy your lives. Because I've seen happen so many people, from young and old. Children and everybody else. You even got kids are so damn bad because, you know, because mom and daddy, you got these sorry mom, these sorry fathers don't want to do nothing. And the best mom and best dad, they do the best they can. But see, they let the lust come in and mess everything up. And now look what they do. They made a mess. Who expect to clean it up? Because it ain't can't be no gallons of tissue. You need to get a mop to mop that stuff up, or a broom, sweep it off the fluffy dusting. We need to get rid of all that. But I say to this, folks, don't use people, not everybody, but don't use people, especially the people that's trying to help you. Don't do that. Because they won't do these other folks like that. They won't do bad folks like that. They always do the good people. And I even said to my uncle, I said, that's who's suffering the most is good people. He trying to say it's not. It is. That's who's suffering the most is good people. If they can't say it's not good people, then who is? Who run the world? It's always been bad people. And then you feel like you got all this stress, and you thinking how long you're going to live, to mourn, to live long. Men do have stress over women, over bills, over all that stuff, man. I don't even have kids, and what I do is stress over the kids. Because I tell you, man, because let's stop trying to blame everybody. Because if you want to blame somebody, you got to blame yourself. Instead of blame the system, blame the men, blame the women, you got to look at towards yourself. What did I didn't do? Do I help everybody that need that I did a good deed instead of doing bad deeds? Because there are people doing bad deeds. Do I did good deeds to fucking clear? I can make a clear end to open the gates of heaven. If I can go in the sea to heaven to do something to be self-sacrifice. Not that blood sacrifice people don't care about, but self-sacrifice. Do I self-sacrifice my family, my friends, my loved ones, and myself for a sacrifice for myself, to my community, my job, anything? Same thing women are doing. What they self-sacrifice the kids, their friends, their loved ones, and their self. Because I'm telling you, man, we can't keep repeating the same mistakes over and over and over and over and over again. The only way we're gonna beat the never end the cycle of hate, the epitome of the spies of hatred, is to break the never-ending cycle, the never-ending cycle of hatred. That's the only way, and we can't keep repeating it itself. Because if we keep repeating it, the history is going to repeat itself by front page of coming out of history books. It's not repeating itself anymore, but it's going to keep repeating itself because it's happened the same cycle over and over again. And we need to stop complaining, stop whining, and let's do something about it. Because we're not doing nothing about it. We need to hold ourselves accountable as a whole, as the city you from and what country you live in, to the country, to everybody else. People, don't get used and then get used. Being used is just you. If you want to feel like you want to get used as being important. You want to be important with somebody important. Somebody be important to you, important to them. But when you try to help somebody, make sure they return the favor. Because if they don't return favor, why doing it? Help people that those who need. Don't help the people that the ones that don't need. Get it? Help the people that are ones who need. Don't help the people that don't need. And then most of all, help yourself. Help your community, help your friends, and help everything around you. And you would get through the miracle working, believing miracles, because everything in this life will become true, and truth come to near you. All right. And it's your boy Domination. This is Back of the Basic, Chunk of the Deuces, how we do it, Texas baby. Until next time. All right. Peace.